American singer and songwriter Larry Wayne Gatlin was born on 2 May 1948 in Seminole, Texas, and is probably best known for being in a band with his brothers, Steve and Rudy. Eventually known as Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin Brothers, finding significant success with the country music genre in the 1970s. So, just how rich is Larry Gatlin? As of early 2017, Celebrity.Money estimates that Larry has a net worth of over $10 million, mostly earned through a successful career in the music industry. The Gatlin brothers have created many hit songs, many written by Larry, and were also responsible for the country style that would eventually be known as Countrypolitan, all of which have ensured the position of his wealth. While traveling around with his family during his youth, Gatlin would be influenced by Southern gospel music and country. He performed with his siblings at their local church and took opportunities to perform on local radio stations too, even recording a gospel music album entitled Sword and Shield. Larry would attend Odessa High School and matriculate in 1966. He was eligible to serve in the Vietnam War, but enrolled at the University of Houston, also becoming a wide receiver in their American football team. He then auditioned for the gospel musical group The Imperials and would later perform at Jimmy Dean's Las Vegas Revue, where he was noticed by Dottie West, who was so impressed with Gatlin's songwriting that she would use several of his songs. She also sent Gatlin's demo around Nashville and helped him relocate there. His net worth was now established. Larry started off with Kris Kristofferson as a backing singer, but would soon find a recording contract opportunity with Monument Records. In 1973, he released his first album entitled The Pilgrim, which failed to chart. However, his song Bitter They Are, Harder They Fall was recorded by Elvis Presley and proved to be successful. The following year, he released another album, Rain/Rainbow, with the single Delta Dirt, reaching the top 20 in country charts. He then had his first major hit with Broken Lady, which reached the fifth spot on the Hot Country Songs chart and led to a Grammy Award for Best Country Song in 1977. His net worth was rising steadily. His brothers would make their first appearance in the albums Larry Gatlin with Family and Friends in 1978 and made his first number one hit with I Just Wish You Were Someone I Love the following year, signing with Columbia Records along with his brothers. They were officially named Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin Brothers, releasing their first album entitled Straight Ahead, which contained their biggest hit, All the Gold in California, with Larry being awarded Top Male Vocalist of the Year by the Academy of Country Music. The band would continue to release hit songs in the 1980s, including Denver, Sure Feels Like Love, and Houston Means I'm One Day Closer to You. The brothers would also become one of the first country groups to make music videos. In the late 1980s, Gatlin's popularity started to decline, and he would record his last few singles with Universal Records. His last charted song would be number one, Heartache Place, before he needed to have surgery on his vocal cords due to wear and tear. The Gatlin brothers would go on a farewell tour in 1992. Larry Gatlin virtually finished his singing career by writing a memoir entitled All the Gold in California and appearing in the film Big Dreams and Broken Hearts, the Dottie West story. Larry has since moved on, and since 2011, he has become a commentator and contributor to Fox News and the Fox Business Network. For his personal life, Larry has been married to Janice Ross since 1969, and they have a daughter and a son. It is known that Larry is a Christian and still continues to serve musically with his brothers through gospel music. He also does a bit of social commentary, and the brothers have a personal joint website, GatlinBrothers.com.